Walls down.
Stay around and watch. It's gonna be great.
Dennis the Menace is sort of an icon. Everybody is familiar with Dennis the Menace.
He's not really a menace. He's just one of those kids that bad things happen to all around.
He just can't help himself getting into trouble.
Daddy doesn't mean to get in trouble. He's curious.
His curiosity kills him almost constantly.
He's just trying to help. Like, he's just trying to be a good kid.
There is a little bit of Dennis the Menace in all of us.
In the room.
Sorry.
We wanted to set this Dennis the Menace in contemporary times, as if Hank Ketcham had written Dennis the Menace today.
We changed the wardrobe. We took him out of the overalls and the striped shirt.
The coveralls and the red striped shirt that he always used to wear in the comic strip. We touch on that for a moment and then move past it. So the audience knows we know we're making Dennis the Menace, but at the same time, they also have to know this is a movie set now.
Why don't you try writing a letter to Santa Claus?
I already emailed him.
The movie's about a six-year-old boy and his relationship with a grumpy old next-door neighbor.
I play George Wilson. We live next door to this wonderful young boy who puts me in such difficult positions all the time.
Hey, Mr. Wilson, you dropped your present.
I think we all have a little mischief in all of us.
Good news, Mr. Wilson. Your mail's all ready to go.
The fun of this is watching this little well-meaning boy trying to obtain the friendship of his next door neighbor.
Hey, Mr. Wilson, what's the matter with your face? Mm-hmm.
Dennis! Mr. Wilson's a little paranoid, you know. He just wants to be left alone.
You're nothing but trouble, Dennis Mitchell. You're a menace. And one more thing. There is no such thing as Santa Claus.
So basically, the heart of the story is Mr. Wilson hates Christmas.
Mr. Wilson isn't a big fan of Christmas.
It's a story about Dennis deciding to give Mr. Wilson the Christmas spirit.
What can I give Mr. Wilson for Christmas that he really, really needs?
And he goes through all these hoops and hurdles trying to get the Christmas spirit to Mr. Wilson.
Dennis the Menace Christmas is really a retelling of the classic Dickens A Christmas Carol.
What the Dickens is going on? Don't be afraid. I'm here to help you. Wait, you're the jerk that was stuck in my chimney tonight.
You can call me jerk if you want to, but I prefer Bob.
Bob is the spirit of Christmas. He is the spirit of warmth and giving and kindness and love.
What do I gotta spell it out for you, Georgie? Come on. The soup, the wings, it's Christmas.
It's like I'm rolling around with Scrooge, and I'm like basically showing Mr. Wilson his life. If he keeps up with his attitude, I said, this is where you're gonna end up lonely, you're gonna end up no one caring about you, and Dennis, who you're being so mean to, he's gonna end up being, you know, lost and lonely.
Dennis, it's me. Give it up, man, it's too late. Forget what I said.
We find out in the context of the story how Mr. Wilson, the grumpy neighbor, became Mr. Wilson. We discover in the story that, in fact, he was a six-year-old Dennis the Menace.
That's me.
And we see that he was the Dennis the Menace of the comic books.
You were really something, huh?
And at the end of the day, Mr. Wilson brings the Christmas spirit back to Dennis.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Yes!
And I take it upon myself and my spirit and in my Christmas spirit to buy him this bicycle. And I give it to him at Christmas time, and he thinks it comes from Santa Claus.
He brought it! There is a Santa Claus!
He brought him the Mighty Max bike. That was amazing.
Mr. Wilson and Dennis, underneath all of the mishaps, actually have a real fondness for one another. And that's the part that the audience is really wanting to see come out in the end.
You are a very good person, Dennis Mitchell. And I'm quite happy to know you.
You okay, Mr. Wilson?
This is the first time Dennis the Menace has been done with an actual six-year-old.
I'm gonna Santa for a new bike this Christmas. Then life in this town is gonna change.
You're counting on a six-year-old to carry the film, and you have to have the right one who's capable of doing that.
We found the perfect Dennis, and he's 6 years old, and he's brilliant.
Maxwell Perry Cotton.
We read lots and lots of kids, but Maxwell Perry Cotton really stood out above the rest.
Maxwell Cotton, what a great name, huh? He sounds like he invented underwear.
Maxwell Perry Cotton is a genius.
I am the best.
And every director is supposed to say that about their leading man, right? Oh, he's a genius, and he's this and that. This kid is as close to a pure movie star as you'll ever see at that age.
Max is a little pro at 6 years old. He knows all of his dialogue. He follows direction. He's got us all really captivated and laughing on set every day.
Now you know how my days have been.
He's as professional as some of our veterans.
How are you?
He's kind of cuckoo. One time I was doing my lines, and I'm like, I forgot my lines. But then, poof, I remembered my lines. Hey, Mr. Wilson, surprise!
Dennis, I might have known you'd have something to do with this.
That's right. I'm your secret Santa.
How did acting get to be so easy for somebody 6 years old?
He has such great instincts, and I think he's going to be one of the big. He's got a tremendous career in front of him.
One of the most fun parts of making Dennis the Menace has been casting Mr. and Mrs. Wilson. You know, there's all these great Hollywood veterans who are the right age now to play this role. Like, who can we choose? And Robert Wagner is a bit of a legend. He's a Hollywood legend, and we thought that bringing that element to the role of Mr. Wilson would really make the entire project stand out even more.
I thought it'd be interesting to try to do this character. I thought it'd be kind of fun.
I told you something was going to go wrong. Come on, let's get out of here.
And cut.
We felt like it was important to cast Mr. Wilson first and then key off of Mr. Wilson for Mrs. Wilson. And once we had Robert Wagner, we knew right away that Louise would work well.
Everybody knows Mrs. Wilson. She's your dream next-door neighbor.
Alice, of course we'll babysit Dennis.
What?
To work with Louise Fletcher is a plus for me. I like that. She's a wonderful, warm, charming, lovely lady.
Merry Christmas.
It's great. I love it.
Robert Wagner.
Action. Ron Oliver, our director, has brought a great sense of fun. He's very colorful and alive and has a big personality, which I think in a movie like this, you really need.
Go, 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 go.
Business like show business.
I went out to all kinds of different directors. I probably met about 14 or 15 other directors, and the one we settled on, Ron Oliver, is somebody I've known for a number of years. And I called Ron.
And he said, I've got this kid we want to do. It's Dennis the Menace. Would you be interested in it?
And he loves Dennis the Menace, and he loves Christmas movies.
I love Christmas. I'm a Christmas guy.
So I said, read the script. Let me know what you think.
So he sent me the script, and I actually welled up with tears, and I thought, okay, I gotta do this movie.
Then we can do a nice slow pan of all the kids, their plot, and that'll give us all that crap.
I mean, heartfelt Christmas magic.
Ron is a very, very funny man, and you know, he brings his own sensibility to his work.
I want to make sure that all you little people out there in the dark are as entertained as I can make you.
There's a certain expectation when you think about Dennis the Menace, like what kind of trouble is he going to get into? Because he's always getting into some sort of trouble.
Ready, guys? Jump!
The thing with Dennis the Menace is that he always tries to do the right thing. So the trouble he gets into is never from him being a bad boy. He's always just trying to do a good thing.
What are you doing?
Dennis?
We have the first one that starts off the movie where all the children in the town are in a Thanksgiving Day pageant. And Dennis notices that the turkey that's part of the show seems to be not very happy.
What's the matter, Mr. Turkey? You thirsty?
Of course, he decides that he's going to get water for the turkey. And when he opens the cage to take the water bowl out and fill it up, he forgets to close the cage. And that's a classic Dennis the Menace moment. You know that that turkey is about to get loose.
It wasn't the original script. And I said, I know, what if it's a live turkey and the kid's chasing it? Everybody went, you're crazy. It's gonna take too much time, you'll never get it done. But hey, we got a live turkey.
I just need one shot of the turkey running back and forth with the kids in the foreground running. The children start running around, trying to get away from the turkey, and the turkey's chasing. So you're always kind of watching this is happening. A little bit over here, a little bit over there, and a little bit of laughter.
Turkey gets out and runs around, and then chaos ensues, and it turns into a food fight.
And then suddenly, out of nowhere, comes food starts to fly. Here comes a food flying duck. You're like, duck!
Everybody is running and crazy, and the turkey's just running through the stage.
Dennis Mitchell.
I had food all over me. Literally, I had like whipped cream on my hair and applesauce on my face.
I get hit by a few pieces of that pastry and slip and get knocked down.
Action, Louise.
Oh, my apple pear pie is ruined.
You and me. Last one to school's a loser. Because that'll be you. Loser!
One of the key threads of this particular story of Dennis is the neighborhood bully, Jack Broucher, who is constantly challenging him and telling Dennis he's a loser. And of course, for the audience, we all know Dennis is not a loser. He's a good kid.
Hey, dork face. Nice race today, loser!
I'm not a loser. Jack Broucher says Christmas is so totally stupid. That's what he says.
Christmas is so totally stupid.
Jack is always bullying and challenging him.
Hey, Slug! Enjoy Christmas Eve tonight, because tomorrow's the day you lose.
Jack Broucher challenges Dennis to a race that's going to happen on Christmas Day at pretty much the end of the film. And Dennis's dream is to get a bicycle that's new and fast from Santa Claus so that he can finally show Jack Broucher that he's not a loser. And so at the very end of the movie, Dennis gets the bike that he always wanted and everything should be going right for him. And Dennis realizes that Jack Broucher is a bully because he doesn't have any love from his own dad.
And if you don't come in first, you're a what? Huh? A what?
A loser!
Good.
And Dennis has love from his family.
And remember, no matter what happens, you're always a winner.
Thanks, Dad.
Okay. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
He realizes that Jack Broucher really needs to win this race more than he does. So he decides he's gonna let Jack Broucher win the race.
Yeah! You won, didn't you? He needed it more than I did.
It's really a uniting moment between these two children that have been at odds with one another, because Jack Broucher realizes that Dennis let him look good in front of his own father.
Thanks. Merry Christmas, Jack.
Merry Christmas, Mitch. Dennis.
This film is a film that when the audience walks out, and they're with their children, their children will react to this picture and be involved in it and feel joy from it. And they will get the Christmas spirit. They will have the Christmas spirit when they finish seeing this picture.
It's what a Christmas movie should be.
Christmas is about family, friends, and love.
The message that I hope will come from the film is that we really do need to appreciate the things that we have all year round. And we have some things to learn from kids as well.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas!
One more thing, folks, is don't wait for Christmas to be nice to each other. Do it every day.
I'm uncomfortable.